Now we are having a question based on the application and linear equations with three variables. Okay, so let's start it now. Converting the equations in the matrix form. Okay. Now A is equal to coefficient of x, y, and z. Okay, 1, 2, 1, 2, -3. 3, 2, -2, 2, -1, 1. X is equal to x, y, z, and B is equal to 6, 3, 2, 6, 3, 2. Okay, we are getting AX is equal to B, or you can write X is equal to A inverse B. After this, we are going to find determinant. Determinant of A is equal to 1 with 2 minus 2, minus 2 with 3 plus 4, minus 3 with minus 3 minus 4. Okay, so this becomes 0 minus 14 plus 21 is equal to 7. Okay, so determinant of A is not equal to 0, therefore A inverse exists. Now let's move with the cofactors. Okay, now cofactor for A11. A11 is equal to 1 minus 1 with 1 plus 1. Okay, so A11 0 is equal to 0. Now A12 is equal to minus 1 with the odd power. Okay, minus 1 with 3 plus 4, this is equal to minus 7. Then A13 is equal to 1 positive with minus 3 minus 4, this is equal to minus 7. Okay, now A21 is equal to minus 1 with, now A21, this is a 2 minus 3 is equal to 1 now. Minus 1, minus 1 is 1. Now A22, we are having 1 with, now A22, 1 plus 6 is equal to 7. A23, we are having minus 1 with, A23 is this part, now we are having 1 minus 4, this becomes 3, 1 minus 4, A23 is this one, sorry, it is minus 1, okay, sorry, it's A23 minus 1, 1 into minus 1, minus 1, minus 4. So this becomes 5. Now A31 is equal to again 1 with minus 4 with plus 6. This is equal to 2. A32 is equal to minus 1. A32, this part, minus 1, now minus 2 and minus 2 plus 9, this is equal to minus 7, and A33 is equal to, now last one, A33, 2 minus 6, 1 with 2 minus 6, this is equal to minus 4. Okay, so here are the cofactors. Now Adjoint of A is equal to, now adjoint cofactor is written in the reverse order. So we are having now this one, 0, minus 7, minus 7, then 1, 7, 5, and then 2, minus 7, minus 4. It is 2 minus 7 minus 4. This is the adjoint process. Now for the inverse. Now x is equal to A inverse B. Now here x is equal to, now what is A inverse? Either you can write A inverse here only, or you can directly put there also. Okay, we can write it here. A inverse is equal to 1 upon determinant of A with adjoint A. Okay, so we are having 1 upon 7. 1 upon 7, because determinant is 7. Then adjoint. For the adjoint part, we are having 0, 1, 2, minus 7, 7, minus 7, and minus 7, 5, minus 4. With B, B is 6, 3, 2. B is 6, 3, 2. Now let's solve it. Now we are having x is equal to 1 by 7. Need not to divide every term with 7. Okay, use this part at the end of the question always. So now this we are getting 0 plus 3 plus 4, then minus 42 plus 21 minus 14, then minus 42 plus 15 minus 8. Okay, see how easy it becomes now. Okay, so now x is equal to 1 by 7. We are having here 3 plus 4, 7. Now 42 minus 42 and minus 14 becomes minus 56. Minus 56 and plus 21 is minus 35. Again, minus 42 and minus 8, minus 50, and 15 is minus 35. So finally, in place of x, we are writing now x, y, z. X is equal to x, y, z, and x, y, z is equal to 1 minus 5 minus y. Okay, so what is the solution now? We are having x is equal to 1, y is equal to minus 5, and z is equal to minus 5. Okay, so finally this is the answer. Now what type of mark distribution? I told you 1 mark for this part. For writing all these things, we are getting 1 mark. 1 mark here, then half marks for this part, 2.5 for all the finding cofactors, 2.5 marks for all the cofactors. And remember, for correct 3 cofactors 1 mark is awarded, for correct 6 cofactors 1.5 mark is awarded. And if you are having 3 cofactors correct, calculation part is okay with whole other question, then your one answer will also be correct. Okay, so finally we are having 2.5 marks for all the cofactors, 1 mark here, 1.5 marks here, then for this calculation part 1.5 marks. So how much marks we are getting? 1, 2.5, 3.5, and half, 4 for this calculation part up to here, and this part, writing this one, 1.5, 5.5, and half marks for the final answer. So this is normally, this question is for 6 marks. And now last thing, what should I tell you? That is, last thing is that because this question becomes so easy question, so what you have to do, just verify the answer for at least 2 equations, at least 2 equations. Okay, it is must. Okay, now you can just take it as a note. Okay, now note, verify at least 2 values. Verify at least 2 values. Now we are having x as 1, x as 1, if we are putting x as 1, minus y is minus 5, minus 10, and z is minus 5, it is plus 15. Now 15 plus 1 is 16 minus 10 is 6. Okay. Similarly, for the second equation, 3 with 1, 3 minus 10 and plus 10. So this and this cancels, 3 is the answer. Now when you are verifying two equations and verification you have done with the two equations, 100% marks are going to be awarded to you. Okay, 100% marks. And if you are suppose not verifying, question is for 6 marks, by chance you are getting by the careless mistake, you just wrote it 1, 5 and 5. Okay, then verification will not be positive. Okay, then you are losing the marks. Otherwise, you can just check it where you are wrong. Okay, so always after finding the answer on the rough part, just go for the verification. Okay.